We all know that at the end of the day, the people will be divided, a group in Jannah and a group in the hellfire. In Surah Ar-Rum, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, on that day, they will be separated. And in Surah Ash-Shura, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. A group in Jannah and a group in the Sa'ir. Now, after the people go to Jahannam and they stay there for a period only known to Allah Azza wa Jal, they will have four wishes. So the first wish, they start with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begging him, and they say,
رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا مِنْهَا فَإِنْ عُدْنَا فَإِنَّا ظَالِمُونَ. قَالَ اخْسَأُوا فِيهَا وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ.
So the first request, they would go to Allah Azza wa Jal and they would say, Ya Allah, bring us back. And if you bring us back and we do something evil, then you can call us zalimun. Ya Allah, do not make us hear these words from you. قَالَ اخْسَأُوا فِيهَا. Stay in it, humiliated, disgraced, all the bad words. وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ. And don't ever talk to me again. So the first wish is they go to Allah and request to go back. Then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that, they come to the second wish. On the second wish, they go to Malik. Who's Malik? The guard of Jahannam. What do they say to Malik?
وَنَادَوْا يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكَ قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ.
يَا مَالِك, tell your Rabb to do what? To kill us. We want to die. They're begging for death. Please, we cannot take this anymore. Malik will answer and say, إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. You are staying there forever. Now that is the second wish. When they gave up on Malik, they go to the guards of Jahannam, the angels. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ghafir, He said,
وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ فِي النَّارِ لِخَزَنَةِ جَهَنَّمَ ادْعُوا رَبَّكُمْ يُخَفِّفْ عَنَّا يوما من العذاب. قالوا أولم تك تأتيكم رسلكم بالبينات؟ قالوا بلى. قالوا فادعوا, وما دعاء الكافرين إلا في ضلال.
They went to the guards of Jahannam and they begged him, please ask Allah to just skip one day. Let's make it every other day. Let's take a break one day a week. Because keep in mind, the people in Jahannam, in front of them, fire. Behind them, fire. To the right, fire. Above them, fire. To the left, fire. Below them, fire. Everywhere is fire. They drink fire. They eat fire. Allahumma ajurna min al-nar. So they say, ya angels, please, we beg you, ask Allah to skip one day. Just give us a break. Angels answer and say, didn't Allah send you messengers with bayinat? Clear. Everything was very clear. Just like we're saying now, ya shabab, my brothers and sisters, wake up. This is true. This is haq. Stop what you're doing. Come back to Allah Azza wa Jal. They said, yeah. Yes, they did. And then here, sarcastically, the angels say, okay, then why don't you make dua? وَمَا دُعَاءُ الْكَافِرِينَ إِلَّا فِي ضَلَالٍ. But unfortunately, all your dua that you are making right now is a waste. They went to Allah first. They went to Malik second. They went to the guards of Jahannam. And now, who do they go to? The people of Jannah. Now, somebody would say, there's a conversation going on between the people of Jannah and the people of the hellfire. Well, it was very clear in Surah Al-A'raf.
وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ أَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَنْ أَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ
So the people of Jahannam, the people of the hellfire, they ask the people of Jannah. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anh, he said, the person will ask his father, the person will ask his brother, give me some water, please, give me anything. مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهُ, from whatever Allah has given you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specified that they request water. The simplest thing, the easiest thing, the most available thing in this dunya will be the wish of the people of the hellfire. Please, just a little bit of water to put this fire, to drink, just a little bit of water. The people of Jannah will answer and they say, Allah made water haram upon you. My brothers and sisters, the four requests that the people of the hellfire make, first from Allah, then from Malik, then from the angels, then from the people of Jannah. Why did this all happen? Why did they get there in the first place? Allah mentioned that in the ayah right after the request from the people of the hellfire to the people of Jannah.
الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَهْوًا وَلَعِبًا وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا وَمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ.
Subhanallah. The main reason why did they get there in the first place is because they took their deen as a joke. Salat 5 times a day, alhamdulillah, I have a clean heart, I'm a good person, I don't harm anybody, why do I have to pray? They did not obey Allah Azza wa Jal. What happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, today you will suffer in the hellfire because of what you did. You ignored the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you will be punished in the hellfire because you used to deny our verses. Finally, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whomsoever asks Allah azza wa jalla to keep him from the hellfire 3 times, the hellfire will tell Allah, ya Allah, keep him away from me. What is the dua? Allahumma ajirni minan nar. Allahumma ajirni minan nar. Allahumma ajirni minan nar.